Happy Walleye Wednesday!
Happy Walleye Wednesday!
Can you say Happy Walleye Wednesday?
Happy Walleye Wednesday!
Say Happy Fishing, everybody!
Happy Fishing, everybody!
What do you think, Walter? Maybe a high five?
A little high five from this Walter.
Walter.
Yeah, baby.
Another great fish. It is not a Bay of Quinte or Lake Erie giant, but something that was brought up to me by Ed McKenzie and James Mathias on Sunday. I've never mentioned it. I mean, everybody knows about taxidermy. And one of the most beautiful things, if you catch a trophy walleye, whether it be in Lake Erie, Bay of Quinte, let's try this again. So we're out fishing with Ed McKenzie and James Mathias on Sunday, and they brought up something that makes perfect sense. Easy boy. You know, if this isn't a trophy by any means, it's a nice walleye, good eating size fish. But if you're out on Bay of Quinte and you're catching a 15-pound fish or Lake Erie, same thing, you know, you don't really necessarily want to take those big fish out of the mix. Because in a lot of cases, especially in some of those landlocked lakes up in northern Ontario, you take out a 9, 10-pound walleye, there's a good chance that that's maintaining your fishery. So an option, which is a great one, is get a replica done. You know, throw the big girl back and get a replica. Advanced taxidermy does amazing work, but it doesn't have to be advanced taxidermy. It could be any kind of taxidermy that does replicas. And I tell you, take all the measurements of your fish, send them in, and you can get a replica for the office, your bedroom, wherever you put something like this, the man cave. I want to thank the two of them for bringing it to my attention, because I never thought to mention it, but it makes perfect sense. Unfortunately, Mother Nature has won again. We are seeking refuge in the truck because it is raining all the way around us. I'm glad I've got the old fish bum hoodie on, because it repels water in situations like this, but I thought I'd take the time to introduce this week's Walleye Wednesday profile. His name is Dakota Desruisseaux. And Dakota, he recently took a trip to Tobin Lake up in Saskatchewan, and he was able to see firsthand what proper management does. They have a slot limit up there, and he mentioned to me on Messenger that he was thrilled to see what proper catch-and-release techniques can do for a fishery. He said he had a fantastic trip. But as I said, you know, he was told that the anglers are encouraged to release the big fish. They have a slot limit. So management is working. As you know, he caught enough for a small little shore lunch, and he released all those beautiful hens that maintain our fishery. He's got two young kids that he's passing this information on to, which is crucial and really important. So here's some of his pictures, guys. His name is Dakota Desruisseaux, and I'm proud to say he is a fellow Walleye Wednesday warrior. Dakota Desruisseaux, he is a big proponent of catch and release, and he maintains that belief everywhere he goes and fishes, and he catches those big hens. Back in they go. Good on you, Dakota. So till next week, guys, tight lines, conserve your waters, catch your limit, but limit your catch, and practice catch and release whenever you can. Till next time, guys, all the best. Take care.